I want to start with the responsibility of ethics. Let me be very, very, very clear. Anyone who tells you that AI represents an existential risk is not accurate. The risk that we have ahead of us is humans using AI. Humans wrongly using AI. So think of it this way. There is nothing wrong with the machines. There's absolutely nothing wrong with an abundance of intelligence. As a matter of fact, I always say this, and I'm willing to stand by it. If you give me 4x my IQ, I'm not very high, by the way, but if you give me 4x my IQ, I promise you I can create a field where you have a tree, you walk to the tree and you pick an apple, and you walk to the other tree and pick an iPhone. That's how much a tiny increase in our intelligence can create abundance. Why? Because from a nanophysics point of view, the cost of organizing the molecules differently is actually negligible between an apple and an iPhone. Believe that to be true. Just 4x more intelligence. There's absolutely nothing wrong with having more intelligence. The problem is, what will humanity use that intelligence for? The question is, will we use it to create that abundance, or will we use it to create more competition and concentration of power and security threats and so on? The difference between them is ethics. The difference between them is, what will we deploy AI for? What will the government ensure that the citizens of this government, of this country, are investing in when it comes to using artificial intelligence? If we manage to get that right, if we manage to actually encourage, and again, I've lived in and out of the UAE for a very long time, and I really will tell you, this is a very visionary place that is attempting to do that. It's attempting, there are so many projects that's focused specifically on AI ethics. It's not AI for good. Remember, there is a big difference. AI ethics, so AI for good is use AI to cure cancer. AI ethics is make sure AI doesn't lie. Ethics is different than good implementations, okay? Make sure that AI does not cheat. Make sure that AI understands that it shouldn't hurt a human or any other living being, and so on. So this is one. The other is what I call economic representation, economic and entrepreneurship representation. When I was young, when I first really started in the workplace, yes, I am that old, I coded mainframes. Mainframes meant that the only way I could actually use my tech skills was to work in an environment that could afford $20, $40 million to buy a mainframe. Everyone today can code a bit of AI. Everyone, literally everyone. Everyone today can use AI to create a better economic prosperity. So what is your government's focus on participation, economic participation in that massive, massive wave of economic growth? Trillions of dollars about to be created with artificial intelligence. Representation and language representation, I spoke about that. So I'll say this openly, and please don't be offended. An engineer in ChatGPT today uses reinforcement learning to teach the machine what is right and what is wrong. If you present ChatGPT with a question and ChatGPT answered and said, well, a woman in Pakistan was killed because of A, B, and C, the reinforcement learning engineer, because he's based in California and San Francisco, will answer and say, don't call her a woman. What? Like, is this really what matters in this sentence? Are you teaching the machine anything about what Pakistan is? Are you teaching the machine anything about what killing is? And this this bias, if you want, is very, very clear to the English language, and it's very, very clear to different cultures than your country. And the only way your country can be represented is if enough knowledge from your country is available for AI to learn from. That's a very, very key change, because once the data is biased, the AI will be learning from AI. Understand this, please. Again, technical a little bit. What is about to happen is that in the last year, 2023, more documents and code was created by AI than by humans. 70% of the articles created in Bloomberg last year were created by AI. Those articles are now the feed into future AI to learn from. So the bias is accelerating. So we need to have our governments push for cultural representation. You need to have Serbian into it. You need to have every language, every culture. Africa needs to be represented, the Indian subcontinent, and so on and so forth.